There's regular and there's decaf. Big difference, right? Well, it may depend on where you're buying it.
If you avoid regular coffee because you don't like the jolt, just hearing this might be enough to wake you right up. According to testing by Consumer Reports, some of the leading coffee stops have high levels of caffeine in their decaf.
I don't think it's right. When you ask for something, you should get it.
All decaf has tiny amounts of caffeine, but some cups of coffee tested by Consumer Reports had far greater amounts. A regular cup of coffee has about 100 milligrams of caffeine. In one decaf sample from a Dunkin' Donuts, it found 32 milligrams. Seattle's Best, 29 milligrams, and Starbucks, 21 milligrams. Health officials say there's nothing wrong with the coffee beans, it's the people handling them, often failing to properly clean the pots and other equipment.
There's a very good opportunity for caffeine to build up inside the walls of coffee containers, of just equipment, even spigots.
Meaning it could happen at any coffee shop or convenience store. A frightening thought for those with high blood pressure who typically avoid caffeine.
If they're not on medication, potentially now we're increasing blood pressure to a very dangerous rate, or even if they are on medication, it can negate the effect of the medication. And so, indeed, this can be very, very serious.
At least for now, if you want to make sure there's no caffeine in your decaf, experts say stop buying the stuff at the store and start brewing your own stuff at home. In Pittsburgh, Aaron Sakin, Channel 4 Action News.